A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th October, Saturday, on the front page you have Central Bank's 25 basis point rate cut leaves market disappointed. So Reserve Bank of India delivered another rate cut, the fifth in as many policy review meetings, to boost the slowing economy. But however, it failed to cheer the market, which was betting on a bigger rate reduction. So the decision on rate cut, that is the key interest rate, the repo rate cut, was taken by MPC, Monetary Policy Committee of RBI. So it decided on to cut interest rates by 25 basis points to 5.1%. So five members voted in favor of this quantum, and R.S. Dholakia wanted a 40 basis points cut. So this is it. The Monetary Policy Committee also has decided to continue with accommodative stance as long as it is necessary to revive growth, while ensuring that inflation remains within the target. So you can see. Also, the growth forecast for the current financial year has been sharply brought down from 6.9% to 6.1%. And for next financial year also from 7.4% to 7.2%. Inflation forecast has been same. It has been retained at 3.5% to 3.7%. Then, this is regarding floods in Bihar. People have been distributed food packets and drinking water. And this is, shooting down of MI-17 was a big mistake, admits IAF chief. So Indian Air Force chief has said action will be taken against two officers. So MI-17 helicopter crash, which took place in Kashmir, it is said which was caused by friendly fire and was by mistake. The crash actually claimed lives of all six personnel on board and one civilian on the ground. This is 49 booked for sedition for anti-lynching letter. So celebrities had written a letter to Prime Minister Narendra Modi in July voicing concern over lynchings. And now 49 people have been booked for sedition for this letter. And you should understand the meaning of sedition. Sedition means acting against the government in words, written or oral. So that is called sedition. Speaking anything against government, and now what is considered against government, what is criticism, there are Supreme Court rulings on it, but this colonial era law on sedition continues to be used by government. So it's not anything related to arms. Sedition is only by speaking, oral, written, in signs, in cartoons, etc. Then this is in a first, US lawmakers take a step against India on Kashmir. So, US Senate panel has made appeal to end humanitarian crisis in Jammu and Kashmir. So, you can see all American lawmakers took this action against India. So, this is US Senate Committee on Foreign Relations. And this is India's first e-waste clinic to come up in Madhya Pradesh capital, Bhopal. So, Central Pollution Control Board will offer technical support here to Bhopal Municipal Corporation. Both have joined hands together to set up country's first e-waste clinic. So it would enable segregation, processing and disposal of waste from both household and commercial units. Then on page 4 you have Ravidas Temple Row. Apex Court tells parties to suggest a better location. So Supreme Court is hearing this case. The Guru Ravidas Temple in Tughlakabad forest area had been brought down. And there were protests by Dalits in Delhi on this. And now the Supreme Court is hearing this matter on permission to rebuild Guru Ravidas temple. So it has said that better location should be suggested. Court said it respected everyone's sentiments and the further hearing will also take place. On page 8, you have 8 fishermen from Vizag, that is Vishakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, held in Bangladesh. So these are fishermen, their boats entered neighboring country, Bangladesh territorial waters, and they were arrested here. And this is Rahul offers legal help on Bandipur. So this is regarding Bandipur Tiger Reserve in Karnataka. Here, night traffic ban has been imposed on a stretch of Kozhikode-Koleru National Highway 766, which passes through the Bandipur Tiger Reserve. So this is actually being protested against. So here you can see that these are protesters on hunger strike on Bandipur night traffic ban. The night traffic ban has also been upheld by the courts. And this is Sri Lanka releases stamp on Mahatma Gandhi. So, in a warm gesture, Department of Post Sri Lanka released a stamp and first day cover to commemorate 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. On page 9, you have High Court green lights axing of 2,646 RA trees. So, BMC, Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation, had allowed chopping of these trees to construct metro car shed. So, Mumbai Metro Rail Corporation Limited was allowed to construct a car shed for its Metro Line 3. And for this, 2,646 trees would be cut in RA. So, protesters had been protesting against this, but now High Court has also given a green light to this. You can see the project has bench rejected the contention stating that MMRCL has scaled down the project with respect to number of trees to be cut, and that itself is a proof of the decision being fair. The bench actually said that petitions, the state has not formulated any policy laying down the parameters to determine either the extent of land or treat coverage therein for qualifying the land as a forest. So here you can see petitioners were seeking to declare 1,280 hectares in RA reserved forests under the Indian Forest Act. So this decision should be taken, and it wanted the court to direct the state to issue a formal notification to that effect under the Indian Forest Act. And it should protect the floodplains of the Mithi River at RA where construction is prohibited. It says when the Mithi River overflows, the low-lying areas in RA Mill Colony acts as a floodplain, and when the river flow is less, the water which accumulates is in the depression feeds the river. So this has to be protected, but cutting down trees here will have drastic consequences. Then on editorial page, the first editorial is moderate expectations. So this essay is about the front page news about RBI's repo rate cut. So it says there are limits to what RBI can do with rates. The government needs to prod investments. So our interest rate cut is not going to have as significant a difference on the economy as government's initiative to increase investments or to push for investments. So last time there was an unconventional rate cut of 35 basis points in August 2019, and presently it has returned to its normal 25 basis points rate cut, as we saw on the front page today. So this is discussing this issue. The economy is slowing down and what steps need to be taken, and there are limits to what RBI can do with rate cut as such. And this is web of deception. So this editorial says that the government must monitor the NEET admission process to guard against fraud. So recently we had seen in Tamil Nadu how NEET, how it has been impersonation in NEET, means somebody else going and attempting the exam for a student. Such cases had come forth, and now there needs to be investigation and monitoring of NEET to ensure that such frauds don't take place. And the lead article is In Search of the Wuhan Spirit. So Mamallapuram summit is going to take place between India and China. This will be India and China's second informal summit. So this article says that it must ensure that it does not provoke China, leading it to indulge in adventurism. So how this summit goes ahead, we'll see. And this is Rethinking College Recruitment. So, there are problems with respect to the college studies as such. So, these underlying problems need to be addressed before the tenure track system is introduced in IITs. So, in 23 IITs across the country, all the 23 IITs, recently they introduced tenure track system. So, under this system, an assistant professor may be hired without the mandatory post-PhD experience requirement, and her performance will be reviewed internally after 3 years. So that is called this system of tenure track system. So based on the evaluation by external committee, at the end of 5.5 years, he or she may either be granted tenure, that is made permanent, and promoted to the next higher level of associate professor, or asked to leave. So that is tenure track system. So the underlying problems need to be addressed, this article says, before tenure track system is introduced in IITs. So there are tenure track system used in other countries also, but then the process does not guarantee excellence or improve accountability at the institutional level. So tenure system in US is to improve performance, is for providing permanency and safeguarding academic freedom. It also promotes research and teaching excellence. There are also IITs which needs funding. So older IITs provide seed funding of about 20 lakh to the new IITs. And the new IITs provide just a couple of lakh of rupees. So you know, seed funding is required. Researchers actually need money to go ahead with their research work. So that is also there an issue. So will the tenure track system make the task of securing fresh talent even more difficult is a question being raised. It is said one director of IIT Delhi, he was not able to find suitable candidates to fill 300 faculty positions that have been lying vacant for the last 10 years. So introduction of tenure track system without addressing the underlying problems researchers face will likely make it even more challenging to find good talent. On UPSC page on Saturdays, you have ground zero coverage, and today the coverage is on Sri Lanka, the tea estates here. It says, often described as the backbone of the Sri Lankan economy, close to 1.5 lakh tea estate workers here have been agitating for fair wages for the last 3 years. And Sri Lanka's presidential elections are due in November 2019. And the laborers feel this will be another time when empty promises will be coming to them. So this is a coverage on their struggle. On page 12, you have President commutes death sentences, 20 death sentences in 9 years. So separately, Ministry of Home Affairs has decided to commute the sentences of Prajwana, convicted in then Punjab CM Baint Singh's killing. So here you can see the commutation of death sentences to life imprisonment has been detailed out. On page 13, you have shun majority minority mindset, says Sheikh Hasina. So this is Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, who is on a visit to India. So here she addressed the Indian Economic Summit, and she said pluralism is fundamental to South Asia. On international page, you have Hong Kong invokes emergency powers. So this is Hong Kong CEO Carrie Lam. She says the colonial era laws allow government to make any regulations whatsoever in public interest. So emergency powers have been invoked now in Hong Kong as protests continue in the fourth month. And this is death toll in Iraq clashes rises to 44. So yesterday we saw clashes in Iraq, demonstrators gathering at Tahrir Square, and armored vehicles with guns as such were shooting on the ground near civilians. So this has resulted in deaths and injuries too. So the death toll has increased now. And this is UAE to invest $5 billion in Pakistan oil refinery project, says report. So this will be a venture which will be launched in Balochistan province of Punjab of Pakistan. On business page, you have income threshold to avail microfinance increased. So lending limit per borrower has also been raised, and the income threshold has been raised. So household income limit of borrowers has been raised from 1.6 lakh for urban and semi-urban areas to 2 lakh. For rural areas from 1 lakh to 1.25 lakh. So microfinance institutions give these loans to such borrowers, and they are uncollateralized, means they do not have any collateral, any guarantee behind them, so like something kept as a guarantee. So income threshold has been increased, and also lending limit per borrower has been raised. And below you have India's e-commerce war of sales and claims. So both Amazon and Flipkart, the e-commerce giants, say their sales for the season are the highest ever in India's e-commerce history. So Amazon says 62% of users who placed orders for appliances have them delivered and installed in 36 hours. And below you have charging infrastructure guidelines for electric vehicles gets not. So there'll be one charging station in 3x3 km grid in all cities. As such, this will be mandated, is what the new guidelines for electric vehicle charging infrastructure approved by Power Ministry says. So at least one charging station will be there. And you can see in all mega cities, and one charging station every 25 km on both sides of highways. So first phase will be completed in 1 to 3 years. Then on last page, you have sports news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.